Hello and welcome all in this video tutorial. In this video we will discuss about the general characters of the fish. I am Jay Kumar. So let us start to focus on different general characters one by one. So basically the fishes are aquatic, that is living in the water, either in fresh water or marine. These are the ectothermic vertebrate organisms. Ectothermic means that is cold blooded. These are the vertebrate organisms. An exoskeleton of this fish is covered by, that is the body of the fish is covered by the exoskeleton of the scales, but few species do not having such a type of scales. Integument contains mucus glands and chromatophores. They are having integument beneath the skin. They are having different type of mucus glands and chromatophores. Then next, the respiration of the fish takes place with the help of the gills. Some having lungs. Some different species like the dipnoi group of fish species having the lungs for the respiration. But generally, the respiration of the fish takes place with the help of the gills. The gills are open to outside by the gill slits, but in some fish which are covered by the operculum, that is gill slits are usually 5 pair, but in some cases there is having 7 pairs of gill slits. That is the basically there are having 5 to 7 pairs of gill slits. There is having a lateral line system, which is a peculiar characteristics of the fish. This lateral line system is found towards the lateral side of the fish in the form of a small pores, and it is a sensitive system which is useful to detect the various changes which takes place into the water. That is, with the help of this fish, with the help of the system, the fish can detect the change in the pressure or vibration. Nextly, next general character, locomotion of the fish takes place with the help of fins. These fins are paired and unpaired fins. These fins, with the help of these fins, which is the locomotory organ, the movement of the fish takes place. And these fins are supported by the fin rays. And this there are having different types of fins, that is unpaired fins and paired fins. The unpaired fins like dorsal fin, ventral fin, anal fin and caudal fin. The dorsal fin, which is found towards the middle position of the dorsal side, ventral fin towards the ventral at the middle mid-ventral portion of the body, and anal fin and caudal fins, which is covers the tail. The paired fins in the form of like pectoral fins and pelvic fins. These paired fins are in a pair, so called as paired fins. This is called as pectoral and pelvic. These are types of the paired fins. Some fishes having the sensory barbels, which is a tactile organ. With the help of that barbels, the fish can get the sensation of the touch. Next, these fishes are first chordates, which is having the nerve cord, notochord and gill slits. That is the purely which in the character which is found in the vertebrates. The fishes are belonging to the vertebrates. Next general character is that there is having a pair of nostrils towards the head in the case of the fish, which is basically olfactory in function, and these nostrils are not useful for the respiration in purposes. That is, nostrils having a pair which is olfactory in function. The body is covered by scales. The scales having basically three types: placoid scales, cycloid scales and tenoid scales. Placoid scales, which is found in the scaldon like fish, cycloid scale and tenoid scale, these are the another type of the scales which covers the entire surface of the fish. Some general characters, remaining general characters are like that. The endoskeleton of the fish is bony or cartilaginous. That is the skeleton which is found in the body, which is called as endoskeleton. This endoskeleton in some fishes are bony, and that fishes are called as bony fishes. Or some the skeleton in some cases the endoskeleton is made by the soft bone, which is called as cartilaginous. The cranium protect the brain. The main bone which is covers the brain, which is called as cranium, and this cranium protect the brain. They are having 10 pairs of cranial nerves in case of fishes. Next, there is having a lateral line system, which is the sensory lateral line system. There is no middle ear. There is inner ear with 3 semicircular canals. There is no middle ear is found in case of fish. Only inner ear is found, and which is made by 3 semicircular canals. The heart of the fish is 2 chambered. That is one auricle and one ventricle. Only one auricle and only one ventricle is having, that is the 2 chambered, the heart in case of fish. And this heart is called as venous heart, because only impure blood comes into this heart. So that heart is called as a venous heart. So the heart of the fish is venous particularly. The kidney is mesonephric type, and there is no urinary bladder. So without urinary bladder, the excretory system is without urinary bladder in case of fish. In fishes, sexes are separate and gonads are paired. That is, testes in case of male and ovaries in case of females are in pair. So the gonads are paired. Fertilization is external or internally, the fertilization takes place into the body. Then these are oviparous or ovoviviparous. Generally, fish gives eggs, so called as oviparous. Eggs are multiple, many eggs are produced by the female at a time, and which is having much yolk. So thank you for watching this video.